Hello friends, welcome to AutoCAD video tutorials. I am Prabhu and you are watching this video from cybercadsolutions.com. In this session I am going to explain how to do page setup in a layout. So first of all, get into layout. Click on the layout button which is on the bottom left of AutoCAD window. Then you will get into layout screen. Now right click on layout button and take page setup manager option. You will get this page setup manager dialog box. Now click on modify button. If you observe the current plot size, it is 8.5 by 11 inches. We will change it to A3 paper size. So click on modify and select paper size. First of all, go to, I am taking 420 by 297 A3 paper size, and we don't have to select any plotter. Just leave it as it is. And what to plot? Layout. So this is also okay. Then scale, it is in custom mode, just change it to 1:1. And again, coming to the color style, if you want to take a color printout, you can take acad.ctb option. Otherwise, if you want to go for a black and white printout, you can select monochrome option. I am selecting monochrome and leave other settings as they are. And landscape and portrait, we are going to take a landscape orientation, so leave this as landscape orientation and click OK to finish. Now you can see the plot size is changed to 420 by 297 and it is already set as current page. So simply say close. Now if you measure the distance from left to right of this white page, you can see that A3 page size will come. So type DI at command prompt and pick on left side and drag your cursor like this. You can observe it is coming approximately around 420. Similarly, the vertical height is 297. You can see that in the screen. Now there is a small viewport, that is the earlier viewport. Simply select it and delete. Now how to create viewport and bring the entities into that viewport? So we are going to use a command called mview. Type mview at command prompt and press enter. It will ask to specify the corner of viewport. I am clicking over here and dragging like this. Now it is asking to specify other corner. Just click over here. So some part of the complete drawing is kept into this viewport. I would like to show only particular plan in this. So to get into the model space of this viewport, you have to either double click inside this viewport or you can use a command called ms to get into model space. Type ms so that you will get into model space. Now you can zoom over here and I am taking zoom command, and in that I am taking object option and select which are the objects to be displayed in this viewport and press enter. So they will be set to the current viewport. Then to come out of this viewport, type ps, which is paper space, so that you will come out of this viewport. So this is how bringing the required objects into a viewport. Similarly, I am going to draw another viewport. So after placing this viewport, if you get into this viewport by double clicking and if you do any pans and zooms, then you will lose the required entities from the current view. So make sure that you just lock this viewport after setting the entities into the viewport. So I'm typing undo u and come out of the viewport by typing ps. Now to lock this viewport view, take mo command, modify properties, and select this viewport and go to miscellaneous properties and take display locked option. Click on yes and press escape. Now if you get into this viewport and even you take zoom or pan, the view will not change because it has been locked. So this is how locking a viewport. Now let us try to place another viewport. Just get out of this viewport, type ps at command prompt and get out. Now type mview again and pick two corners to get this viewport. So the same view which is kept in the first viewport is being coming. So I want to get the first floor view into this. For that, you just double click in this viewport, or you can use ms command also and take pan command to pan the sheet to get the first floor into the current view, and to come out of this viewport after setting required entities into the zoom, type ps set command prompt and press enter. So this is how creating viewports and bringing objects into the view of each viewport. Then we will see how to set scale. So if you want to lock this viewport, just select this and go to miscellaneous properties and take display locked option and click on yes, so that even you unfortunately get into this viewport and do any zooms, the view won't get changed. Then now we will see how to set the scale to a viewport. I'm deleting these two viewports and I'm going to take a new viewport. So type mview at command prompt and I'm going to click over here, and for other corner I'm giving my input like this at the rate 420,297, which is A3 sheet size. You can see all the drawing is coming up here. Now to get the required complete drawing, get into this viewport. For that, type ms at command prompt, so that now we are inside this model space. So zoom out like this and use the command zoom and option extends e, so that all the entities will be brought into this view. Now to come out of this window, type ps, so that we are out of this viewport. Now to set the scale, take mvo command, modify properties, and select the viewport like this from the outside edge and go to miscellaneous properties. Here the standard scale is custom, but this drawing has been done in 10:1 scale, so I am going to change that to 10:1 scale. Sorry, so here it is, just select that one, so that you can see the drawing is exactly fit into this current viewport, since the paper size is also A3 paper size to which this drawing has been drawn. Then to lock the display, go to display locked property and select yes. Now some people may have a doubt that what is the use of setting a scale. So setting a scale means if you measure the distance after switching off this object snap, you can see it is exactly 1/10, because 10 units are taken as 1 unit. So if you measure, you can see the difference. I'm going to measure over here, take di command and pick a point over here and pick the other point over here. You can see here 28.46 is coming, that is nothing but 28.5 units. Because we are using 10:1 scale, the original drawn scale is 2.85. actually its measurement is 28.5, so that is reduced to 1 unit, that is 10 units are considered as 1 unit. So 28.5, that is drawn as 2.85. so when you take a printout, then if you use a steel rule to measure the distance over the paper, exactly you will find that this drawing is 10:1 scale drawing. So that is the use of using scales on layouts. So how to do that? Simply select the viewport on the edge, take modify command and change standard scale. So here it is, we have already set it. Present why it is not coming, because display has been locked, so we cannot change the standard scale. If you want to change standard scale, first of all you need to unlock the display, then you can change the scale to required value. So once after setting this standard scale, just lock your viewport, so that others unfortunately won't change your view settings. So this is how setting page setup and creating viewports and bringing entities into the viewports, and also setting the scale and locking the display. Hope you understood. Friends, if you like this video, please subscribe to my channel and share this video to your friends. Thanks for watching and welcome to the next session.